What's up, guys? It's Devin with Primetime Sport Fishing, and welcome back to an episode. All right, so we're back out going for these crawfish, and we're not messing around this time. I got the reel trap there, and I got some bacon. We got the pole, and we're in a new spot. We're underneath the 505 bridge here at Poudre Creek. So I'm gonna throw the trap in the water. It's a little bit deeper here, so I feel a lot more confident in this trap this time, because we got a real crawfish trap. And yeah, so we're gonna see what happens with that. I'm gonna try it with the fishing pole with some bacon on it, and yeah, we'll go from there. Let's do it. All right, so we got the trap. We got a whole bunch of bait. So I'm gonna throw in that's an old piece of salmon. That thing was in the bottom of the freezer. We also got some bacon. I hear this is the magic weapon. Ugh. This stuff is old too. This bacon was like expired in like 2019. So there we go, secret weapon bacon. And I don't know, here's some anchovies. We could try throwing some of these in. A couple anchovies. Oop. Let's get that sucker out. Okay. All right. That seems like a good amount of bait for this thing. Right? I don't know. All right. Next step. Put the dang majang. Perfect. And then, should I get that bait right in the middle of it? Really find it. Okay, that one felt a little better. Okay, I think that's it. Woo! I'm excited. I think we figured it out. Now, in the meantime, I got on my last crawfish video, someone said, try putting bacon on a hook. And he actually told me, try underneath the 505 bridge. He said he tears it up, so I was like, all right, let's do it. So here's the bacon. I'm a hook, and I'm not really sure, because you gotta kind of see them. So I think I'm gonna go down right there. There's a spot. It's got a little bit of sunshine going into the water, so we're gonna try. Oh, look at that, look at that. You're joking, bro. Look at that. Right there. There's a whole bunch of, oh my gosh. I see two crawdads. I dropped it right in front of his face. Bingo, he's on it. All right. Do I just pull him up? Uh oh, he let go. Oh my God. I let him eat it for a while, I think. You guys see that? Right there. There's one, and then the other one, where'd he go? I think I kind of scared him. We'll give it a minute. Dang, dude. Right off the bat. Okay, he's back on it again. I'm coming slow. Let's go. Yes, sir. Oh, he's a nice one. All right, let go. There we go. These dudes are heck of lively. There we go. That's number one. All right, we're eating him. We're gonna eat him. Let's get things situated. I'm gonna put him in the cooler. And yeah. All right, here we go. Got the cooler with water. Crawfish is ready. Well, not ready, but he's in the cooler. And yep, let's catch some more. Shoot. You know what? I have an idea. I brought my snorkel goggles right there. I'm gonna get in the water. Probably go over there where I could see. It's too dark over here. And I'm gonna just grab it with my hands, because last time that's what I did and it worked. And there's obviously a lot more here, so we're gonna scratch this idea because it's a lot harder than I thought. So we're getting in the water. All right, goggles are on. Don't make fun of me now. These are the only goggles I can find. I'm not even sure whose they are, but we're going in the water and got the camera. So y'all, I'm gonna bring you guys with me and let's see what we can find. Oh, yep, right there, first one. Oh, it's a big guy. Yep, that's what I'm talking about. Number two. But now I gotta go all the way. I should've brought like a bag with me. Oh well, guess I'll have to go back.
All right, here we go, there's another one right there.
Ow, he got me. Let go. Let go. Ouch. Damn. Okay, he got me double. There we go. That guy jacked me up. Eh, he's big enough to eat. I got a bag right there. We'll put it in this bag. Just drop him in. Bloop. Perfect. So I have to keep going back and forth. Got him. Ooh, I grabbed him by the claws. Sweet. We'll throw him into the bag there. That is number five, I think. Snap, there's a jumbo guy right there. Where to get him? 1, 2, 3. Got him. Got him. This might be the biggest one of the day. Sweet. All right, well, we got three in the cooler. And I got another three in here. So, and I think it's been almost 2 hours. So I think it's about time to check the trap. So I'm gonna pull it up. Hopefully we got some in there. All right. Well, it's like 5:30 now. So we've given it a lot of time. Let's see. Oh man. What do we got? What? Are you kidding me? Empty? Dang. Aw, man. Well, that stinks. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go up river a little bit, and I saw a real rocky where I was catching them. And I'm gonna place it up there, because maybe it was too sandy or something. I don't know. If you guys have any tips, let me know down in the comments, because I don't know what I did wrong. I think my bait was pretty good, so I don't know. That's a bummer. All right, well, I've gone upstream a little bit and found a lot more rocky here, so I'm gonna try tossing it just like right there. Maybe we'll have some more luck right there. All right, so I figured out what was going wrong with our trap. So the current was pushing like all the bait to one side, and the crawfish were able just to reach in and just grab the bait without even going into the trap itself. So I just said screw the trap idea. All the crawfish were coming out just from the smell of it. So I was like, I'll just grab them as they come out. As you could see, I doubled up in this one, and there's another one I missed.
I missed a really big one. Dang it. Oh well, I got two.
Got a big guy.
All right. Well, I think we caught enough.
Got about 6 or 7 in there. Now just
as I see him crawl up to the trap, I just grab him and stick him in the trap. So in a way, the trap did work, but not exactly how I wanted. But Jesus Christ, it's cold.
Let's open up the trap and see how many more we caught. There's 2. There's 4. There's 5. There's 6. There's 7. And 8. Alright, well, I can't remember how many we had to start, but dang, that dude tore my finger up. Since we're going to be eating these crawfish, I thought it'd be a good idea to kind of scrub them off. Alright guys, so we got the stove all ready to go, and we got the heat on, pan is warming up, got the crawfish in there, all cleaned up, and today we're just going to be basically boiling them in butter. I got like over a cup of butter in here, and we're going to put a whole bunch of butter in there and basically boil them in butter. Shout out to Ace Videos. I actually watched his YouTube video, and that's where I got the idea from. And yeah, so wait for this to get heated up. Step 1, add the butter. I don't know how much I'm gonna use. We'll start with 1 stick, which is a lot of butter already. Next step, we're gonna grab one of these guys. Big guy. I guess we'll just toss him in. Ooh, he's popping. Grab another one, toss them in. All right, y'all see that right there, how it's like split? That's how you know it's done. I'll just grab them by the claw. Yeah, he's all split right there. He's done. And we'll just place him up here. Oh, snap. All right guys, now for the moment we've all been waiting for, the taste test. So crack the tail off, just like that. Take that tail piece off, bingo. Crack that off. Let's see if I can get the whole thing to come out. Here it goes. Oh, money. Miniature lobster tail. Let's give it a try. I mean, that's pretty good. For not having a kitchen and just cooking in the back of the truck and only using butter, not bad. Anyways, Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Please subscribe, because like I said before, once we hit 500 subscribers, I'll be having a merch drop. I'll have hats, hoodies, sweatshirts, all that. I already have the designs made. I just need you guys to subscribe. So make that happen. If you're watching by now and you ain't even subscribed, go ahead, hit it. Mine as well. But yeah, hope you guys enjoy the video. Please remember to like, comment, subscribe. And we'll see you on the next one.